Greetings, YouTube. This is the Hero of Tomorrow, and yeah, it's been a while since I brought up the Lloyd pictures, hasn't it? Well, I think it's kind of fitting given the nature of this announcement, because pretty soon I'm going to be hanging up these images for good. At the moment that I'm making this video, I'm approaching 600 subscribers. In fact, I'm less than 10 away from getting there. Pity, because after this is over, I think I might be losing a few. I know some of you may find it hard to believe, but there are actually some people who enjoyed the few commentaries that I made, and at first, so did I. But lately, I don't know, it just seems like I'm running out of material. I'm not going to go into some spiel about how the community is dying, because honestly, whenever someone says that, it's bullshit anyway, because there's always going to be bad videos to mock, and there are always going to be people who are good at riffing on them. The thing is, though, recently I found that commentating just isn't as fun anymore. Don't get me wrong, making fun of that review for my 500 sub special, that was fun. But here's the thing, that review was a few years old by the time I got to it. And believe it or not, I think people are actually starting to pay more attention to what they put on YouTube, since there are a lot of commentators out there now. Cause honestly, lately, even with reviews that I disagree with, I can see that people are actually putting more effort into them. Hell, if even RJ Bansma is starting to act like more of a good guy, then you know that something's going better. And frankly, I never felt I was that good at commentating to begin with. For one thing, I'm kind of too much of a nice guy. A lot of commentators usually make comedy out of making fun of the person they're commentating on. I rarely, if ever, do that, and I'm a lot more soft-spoken than most commentators, too. Now, there are some people who can make that work, like Savage Broadcast, whose delivery is a lot better than mine anyway, but apparently half of the commentary community really doesn't like my videos, which was news to me. But I'm not stopping because some people don't like my stuff. Hell, no matter what you do or where you go, there are gonna be some people who dislike what you do in life, and I accepted that long ago. But when I started this channel, and even when I started my old channel, I started out by doing a lot of different things to see what I was good at. AMVs, rants, top 10 lists, but eventually I moved on to reviews and later commentaries. And despite what some people may say, I still think that reviewing is what I'm best at, and I want to stick to that. I like reviewing movies, I like riffing on bad fanfiction, because to me, making those videos are the most fun and the most rewarding. I had fun making some commentaries, in fact, I still like a lot of what I've made, but nowadays, I just don't feel like doing them anymore. So yeah, I think this is actually going to be a permanent change, and I'm going to stop doing commentaries. And even if this isn't permanent, it's not coming back for a long time. But before I go on to the second main point of this video, there's something that I want to talk about, and that's actually based on one of my commentaries. Now, people are going to call me a white knight regardless, but I'm just going to clarify. I still stand by supporting James with his movie, mainly because I still think a lot of people who were against it didn't take into account just how expensive making a movie truly is. And honestly, while Mike Matei isn't the best video game reviewer out there, I think a couple of his reviews recently are genuinely good. I loved his Wario World review, and it's because of his review that I bought iNinja recently, and I'm really enjoying it so far. But there's something that happened recently that some people were curious as to what I thought about it. Namely, the Cheetahmen 2 Kickstarter. Now, like with the movie, a lot of commentators brought up points against it, and I watched the videos that TOG and Danger Mouse made on it, and you know what? Unlike what the Archfiend said about the movie, these guys were totally right. Cause unlike with a movie where there are tons of expenses that no one seemed to see, TOG and Danger Mouse were able to highlight exactly how much it would cost to get all of the components the guy who was running the Cheetahmen Kickstarter was advertising. And the answer, in short, was way fucking less than what the guy was asking for. So no, I do not mindlessly support everything the AVGN does. In fact, I thought this was completely stupid. For what it's worth, from what I hear, they've withdrawn their support from the venture, and good for them, because they should have done it a long time ago, and I think it was insanely stupid of them to support it. Now, granted, I don't think that just because a person makes a bad decision makes them a bad person, unlike what most of the people involved seem to think, but I think that's all that I need to say on the subject. Finally, provided I don't lose a lot of subs based on this video, my 600 subscriber special should be coming up soon. And some of you may be wondering at this point, if I'm not making commentaries, then how am I going to celebrate this milestone? Well, since Halloween is coming up anyway, and there's a review from my past that I've wanted to remake for a while due to technical issues that it had, I know exactly what I'm gonna do. For those of you who are unfamiliar with my old channel, you probably don't know what I'm talking about. Well, here's the explanation. I am a huge fan of The World Ends With You, and on my old channel I did a huge Game Den style retrospective of the game, which you can't even see all of anymore due to copyrighted music. Seriously, fuck copyright Nazis. But either way, that review needs remaking anyway because I don't think I did the game justice. So for my 600 sub special, I'm gonna redo my review of The World Ends With You. Try saying that 5 times fast. But anyway, that's all I have to say, and I hope you don't mind the new direction this channel's going to go in. So with that being said, this is The Hero of Tomorrow, and for the last time as Lloyd, I'm signing off.